Hello and a very warm welcome to coverage of round 16 of the late breaking online racing league. My name's Ben Hocking.
My name is Harry Ead.
And my name is Samuel Sage, and I cannot believe we're up to round 16.
Yep, just five more to go before we crown ourselves a first ever champion. The circuit this week is the Shanghai Circuit in China. The drivers will be doing 28 laps, having to deal with that enormous back straight, which will be interesting to see, no doubt.
Yeah, we could see a fair bit of drafting down there, as the Americans like to say.
Yes, drafting indeed, yeah. But don't forget, you know, the first two sectors, they are technically a little bit tricky, so you need a setup that can do both. We're on board with Noob. He was able to reclaim the championship lead last time out in a, well, it's only 2 points, as he's clear of Jack Hickey in the Toro Rosso at the moment, with Sam Sage, the Googles, and Khan's not too far back. Be interesting to see whether he can maintain his lead today.
Yeah, after the chaos of Suzuka, Noob somehow managed to regain the lead.
You can see it's a relatively full lobby today, 14 drivers, including one new driver, that's Johannes. He will be driving the McLaren today, I believe.
Johannes is in a McLaren. Where is he? Oh, he's on his outlap. Let's go and have a look at him. Yeah, you're right. In a McLaren. Right behind his teammate, Pat O'Hagan. This is not ideal for Noob. I don't know why he started his lap so close to Gilly. I mean, he'll get a nice little toe down this straight, but the rest of the time, he's just going to be got that dirty air for the whole lap.
Yeah, I mean, he's still on max, so he is going for it.
Yeah, Noob does beat Gilly's time. And then overtakes him for good measure. Going for another run, is he? Might well be.
And Sam falls in behind the pair of them. So Noob currently has the fastest time, a 133.5. Gilly, 133.8. Sam, a 134.
Going for another run because it was a very poor lap. A lot of backsliding.
oversteer.
Yeah, I mean, backsliding is the
official term. I prefer backsliding.
Backsliding is the technical term for oversteer, actually, yeah.
Purple Petrol has gone a little bit slower than Curly Apex, so maybe be looking to improve on that time, a 136.4, as Bilal Khan is about to go onto his lap.
Yeah, I think he's on an outlap. Sienna in the Renault does a 144.1, so a little way off. Bit of a sight for that.
Not going to break any records, is it?
Not quite, no.
Johannes has gone third. He's gone a tenth slower than Gilly and a tenth quicker than Sam, so falls in nicely in that lead group. As Hickey goes fastest, the 133.4.
Nice, that's a big lap for Hickey. 2 tenths clear of Noob in the second. Could Hickey get his first ever pole?
Hey, we're still waiting for it. Maybe looking to do a Niki Lauda and win the championship without getting a pole position. Khan's and Noob have four poles each, and Khan's not going to do quite enough this time out. Goes in between Noob and Hickey into second place. Yeah. As Bilal Khan is actually, I think he might have abandoned his lap. So
how is his lap 6 minutes? That can't be right.
Yeah, I think
odd one, but he hasn't set a lap time, so is he now going to start? No, he's not
going to have the fuel to do a full lap on max fuel.
We've got Lopez warming his tyres very vigorously on this outlap, wants to get as much heat in them as possible, and now he's going to start his flying lap.
Well, we've seen Lopez often goes out when it's quietest on track. Sometimes it's worked, sometimes it hasn't. We'll have to see whether it does today.
It's always nice just to not have to worry about traffic. So, quite a good strategy, although it only really allows him to do one, maybe two laps.
Had a pretty good qualifying performance in Japan last time out. He was only a tenth off, I think it was a tenth off Bilal Khan in third. So if he's in that sort of area again, I think he's going to be pretty happy.
Oh, he's abandoned this lap then.
Yeah, he's obviously not liking that one.
Have a look who that
is. Yeah, that's the Mercedes, Purple Petrol.
Seems like an odd one. Seems like he's been for a bit of a spin. That's just before the main back straight. Getting out of the way there.
Yeah, if you're looking to pick up speed as you go onto that straight, that is not exactly the way to do it, but I'm sure he'll get another lap in and look to improve on that 136.4. He's got Curly Apex just ahead of him. You'd think seventh place is attainable. Both Renault drivers in the race today. Curly Apex improves quite a bit, but it's not enough to move any positions. A 135.1.
So I think Noob is going to be... Oh no, it'll be Sam who's our first big contender across the line.
He does have the fuel to do one more if he wanted to. We'll have to see how good this one is.
through the final corner. Here he comes.
Tricky final corner to negotiate. You've got to maintain speed as much as possible. And Sam goes second. Narrowly loses out to Hickey there, but that's a massive improvement on where he was. Let's have a look at Noob. And he gets provisional pole by nearly 7/10.
That's a what big a lap. And he's not going for another one. No, he can't anyway. But yeah, that's Noob done for the session. We'll have to see what.
132.8.
Hickey's looks like he's getting out of the way of people, so this isn't going to be his fast lap as DJ Marshall goes whizzing past him.
We saw Noob do something so similar in Japan where he set that lap that was much quicker than everything else that was set, and then guys kind of went quicker but not quick enough to get the pole position away from him, looking for two in a row.
Yeah, definitely. Here comes Khan's, and he's going to come across a very slow Jack Hickey towards the end of his lap. Hopefully Jack will get out of the way. Oh, Noob locked up, makes the apex though.
Khan's really desperate for a win today.
Yeah, he's got Hickey just in front, shouldn't be too much of an issue.
Khan's coming out the final corner. Will he improve on his 133.5? He does, a 133.1, but it's not enough to displace Noob from pole.
Gilly's 33.5. Khan's has retired. He's out. He's had enough. Lopez goes third. That's a massive lap.
Good improvement from Lopez, and he'll be the quicker of the two hash drivers today as Gilly's retired and done. And Bilal Khan goes second. Bilal Khan so close. Manages to out-qualify his brother, but not out-qualify his teammate.
So we'll have to see. We've got Johannes should be... Yeah, he's on a lap.
And he's about half a second up, actually. So I think he'll make up a position or two.
Wiser Dragons has now set a lap, goes a P11.
Yep, goes above both Siema and Pat O'Hagan for the time being. Johannes in his first race. Where can he qualify? Fourth. He's gone quicker than Lopez, narrowly.
Oh, who was that? Oh, I think
I think that's all done. So it is pretty much just Jack Hickey left of the front runners who may get pole position. It's a Red Bull 1-2 at the moment. Can Hickey separate them? Can Hickey beat them both? Can he claim pole? Second place, it's so close.
He splits them and just misses out on pole position.
Half a tenth, that is it between the two drivers. And
DJ Marshall not setting that whatsoever, so we'll start in 14th.
Yeah, I think that's going to do it then.
Oh, CM has put it in the wall just at the end of the session, just for good measure there.
Good measure indeed. For the second race in a row and for the fifth time this year, it's going to be Noob who starts from pole position, and Jack Hickey, his nearest championship rival, will start alongside him. In third and fourth are the Khan's brothers. Bilal Khan ahead of Khan's on this occasion. Johannes in his first race has qualified fifth. Good effort from him. Lopez is sixth, the lead hash driver. Seventh is Sam, as he separates the two hash drivers, with Gilly in eighth. Curly Apex is ninth, and Purple Petrol is 10th. Outside of the top 10 is Wise of the Dragons in 11th, ahead of Pat O'Hagan in 12th. Siema will start from 13th, and DJ Marshall, who wasn't able to set a lap, will start 14th. Mayner has also joined in qualifying, so he will start 15th. As the cars file out on the formation lap, first of all, an apology to DJ Marshall. We had him down at the back of the grid without setting a lap, but apparently he set a lap that was good enough for ninth place. So much better starting position than we thought, at least.
Yeah, don't know what happened there, but glad to see DJ Marshall in ninth.
Yeah, so hopefully, we'll see a mix of strategies that you can either do maybe a two-stop if you're starting on the super soft tyres. Anyone outside that top 10 who might be going for the soft tyre might be able to one-stop it. So maybe that'll play into the proceedings today. As all 15 drivers filing up.
Yeah, Mayner's in a Williams, by the way.
Should be in a Toro Rosso, but we can pretend. Massive championship permutations heading into round 16. Noob and Hickey start on the front row, and it's lights out, away we go.
Hickey's
got a decent enough start, actually. He may be contending with Noob going into that first corner. He gets in its slipstream instead. Sam manages to overtake Lopez and Johannes at the start, so really good from him. And Khan's has gone into third. I think Bilal Khan's had an incident. He's down in seventh place.
Yeah, he just sort of fell off the road a bit, but so far we've got everyone still in the race.
It's a dream start from Sam up to fourth.
Yeah, nailed that one. And Johan is in fifth. Yeah, Bilal's had an is. Oh, and Lopez is.
Lopez, that's an ambitious move.
Gone straight at the inside of Johannes. I think he's made it stick, though.
Yeah. So, as we have it, the top four drivers are the top four in the championship, and Johannes has had him off.
Oh, no.
There's carnage. And there's a Renault driver gone. I think that's Curly Apex, and he's retired from the session.
Curly Apex is out.
Oh, that is ridiculously bad luck as the other tyre goes, just to add insult to injury.
Yeah, that 2x2, we've seen that in real life, doesn't work through there, and it didn't that time either. Tapped around, Lopez, I think, tapped around by our new boy, Johannes. Meanwhile, Jack Hickey's being very pressured by Carnes.
Yeah, Noob has pulled out a bit of a gap here. It's almost a second, and Carnes is going to be competitive going into the hairpin. Is he going to be able to make something happen around the outside with Sam and Johannes just behind the two of them?
Yeah, and that's allowed Sam to close right up to the back of these three.
You couldn't ask for anything more. The top four in the championship all have a theoretical chance of winning, and they're all battling out on track at the top.
Yeah, Bilal is struggling back in sixth place with Gilly for company at the moment.
Yeah, and Gilly is literally right on his tail as well. He might have a chance going into turn one, and yeah.
Oh, Gilly, we got more carnage. Pau Hagen and Lopez.
Sam and Carnes battling away.
Yeah, a little bit of contact there. Can't see if hit my side.
It's all going off on lap, well, two now of the Chinese Grand Prix here.
Yes. Oh, there's not much to separate Sam and Carnes at all on board with the Sauber driver now.
Yeah, Bilal Carnes' pace seems to have just dropped off.
Oversteer, letting it through.
Oh, and Johannes has got fourth place from Sam. Sam very close to getting third place and is now going to have to stare at the back of the McLaren.
Yeah, such a tricky.
I'll have him soon, boys.
Confidence oozing from Sam Sage there.
As Noob has been able to keep that 1 second plus gap, that's going to be very useful when DRS comes into play in just a little bit.
Meanwhile, we've got Purple Petrol not far behind Siema, but can't do anything.
Yeah, Siema the only Renault left running now as Mayner is battling with DJ Marshall here for eighth place.
That's a tricky corner, yeah.
Oh, and DJ Marshall just about keeps it, and I think Mayner's lost a little bit of front wing there.
Can't.
And Mayner has got past DJ Marshall, actually. Mayner has got the move done. We saw he nearly got it done in the final corner, and later on in that lap, he has.
Sam slowly cruising up to the back of Johannes again. DRS will be enabled this lap, and Johannes will not have the benefit of it, and the same for Carnes and Jack Hickey.
Yeah.
Jack Hickey's not going to have DRS either.
Well, I don't think he will. It's close, though. It is close. I think he will just lose out on it. Carnes definitely won't, though. And DJ Marshall has got past Mayner again, so the two continue to battle.
They're in a right old ding-dong, these two, aren't they?
They really are.
Oh, Mayner.
Mayner's got it back once more. Look at them. They're side by side as they cross the start-finish line.
Great racing between the two. We didn't see DJ Marshall race last week because he lost connection, but oh.
Judging by that, it's a mighty shame we didn't get to see him race because this is entertaining stuff. Mayner gets the place back once more, but we saw DJ Marshall reclaim it once already.
Great battling all through the field. That's what we like to see.
Absolutely.
My favourite person is catching up to this fight. It's Gilly.
There's your mates, mate.
Yeah, Gilly is, as you say, making up some ground. The battle's going on ahead, and Gilly's got a clear track at the minute, so it's going to help him.
We were speaking about the two Haas boys as Wiser Dragons gets a 3 second time penalty. You're speaking about two Haas boys getting the jump on the Red Bulls. They're not going to do too well with Lopez down in 11th, but long way to go. And we've seen Lopez make some good recovery drives before.
Oh, Carnes and Hickey get very, very close. And now Hickey's going to have to defend really harshly here if he wants to keep Carnes behind him.
Don't think he's going to be able to. We'll have to see.
Carnes, with the aid of DRS, surely going to look to make a move down into the hairpin. And they're so close to contact. Hickey, in the meantime, has kept the place. Johannes forced to defend the inside as Sam has closed right up on him.
Yeah, I thought Carnes could have gone for that one then. He certainly had the edge, but
maybe Carnes playing the long game as we begin lap five. The action still coming thick and fast here.
Sam once again.
Sam pressurising Johannes still, hoping he'll make a mistake somewhere.
Ooh,
hasn't
Johannes
done so yet.
Oh,
and they're close to contact there.
Sam cuts back. Ooh, just clip the curve slightly. And Johannes maintains fourth place for now.
And DJ Marshall once again has got eighth place back from Mayner.
These two are having such a battle. It's incredible.
And as far as we've been able to see, it's been all clean as well.
Yeah, slight contact earlier on, but it wasn't anything too major, was it?
Yeah.
Maynard cutting back, wants to try and dive down the inside. Is he going to go for it? Yes, he is.
He is going to go for it, and there's a lock-up, and DJ Marshall is going to hang it around the outside expertly there.
This is great stuff.
And DJ Marshall keeps it.
Drive together on a pretty much a regular weekly basis, so the boy can overtake.
I thought you said Ding Dong then, and actually Meatball up at the front.
Yeah,
he's closed up to within a second, so he'll get some DRS help this straight, which will help him.
Maybe not the best lap for Noob. Just the second separate Noob, Hickey and Carnes now.
Yeah, look at this, top three so close together,
and there aren't going to be any experimental dive bombs going into the hairpin, but they will stick very, very close to each other indeed, as will Sam on the back of Johannes, desperate to get past the McLaren driver, wants to reclaim that fourth position. And Carnes has gone into the lead because Noob and Hickey are both pitting.
And
Sam is coming to the pits with front wing damage. Did you get that on the way into the pits?
Yeah.
Okay.
The McLaren driver stuck a lot sooner than I thought he was, and I just took the back of him.
Yep, so Hickey, Noob and Sam all in the pits.
Oh, that's a slow pit stop for Hickey. That's not ideal because he had Sam coming past him.
Yeah, that might cost him.
And they're not changing my front wing either.
Oh, nightmare for Sam. And Noob has come out in the middle of the main of DJ Marshall, but
He's got past Maynard, but not past DJ Marshall. Hickey and Sam obviously behind those guys.
And Hickey has lost out heavily here because he was right behind Noob, and look how far up the road he is now.
I have to say, I did have the planned first pit stop to be a couple of laps later than that, so
perhaps they're going, well, perhaps Noob's wary of an undercut and Hickey's going for an undercut, but at the moment I'd say the undercut isn't going to work.
We'll have to see what Carnes does out front, whether he'll keep going for a few more laps or whether he comes in as well.
We'll have to see if Noob and...
I'm losing so much speed.
We'll have to see if Noob and Hickey get held up behind this battle. I think Noob probably going to dispose of DJ Marshall pretty quickly, but we'll have to see.
Yeah, those fresh tyres, fresh soft tyres, that's the same for Hickey as well. So maybe looking to do super soft, soft, soft.
Yeah, and Noob up the inside of DJ Marshall. I think it's going to be pretty straightforward here for the Red Bull driver.
Yep. It looks like he's got the place in. Well, to be fair, they're still pretty much side by side.
I think DJ Marshall's taking it back.
Yeah, DJ Marshall perhaps got a bit of a better line coming out of that corner.
Yellow at second two.
Noob has managed to claim that one, which he'll be very, very happy with because he knows that Hickey is behind the pair of them. Sam not fancying carrying on with that front wing damage. He's going to come into the pits a lap after he was first there.
You're going for medium, Sam?
No, I'm going to go for another pair of softs. I can't take medium to the end. I guess that front wing was killing me.
As we can see now, the top five guys are 5 seconds clear of each other.
Five.
Any fans of symmetry out there will absolutely love that.
Any fans of symmetry?
Good God.
Hey, there are lots of them, Sam.
Yes, as you say, more importantly, Bilal Khan is into the pits.
So we'll see what he puts on. Probably soft tyres, I would imagine. Super soft.
Yeah, it is a soft tyre.
So, yellow stripes. Oh, and a new front wing too.
Yeah, maybe he had damage, which is what was slowing him down a little bit. DJ Marshall is also into the pits. We'll have to see what he puts on, and that looks like the super soft tyres again. Yes, he is going straight on, and we'll have to see where he comes out and what tyre he puts on.
Johannes does the same, and will Giddy follow suit? No, he carries on. Giddy goes for another lap.
Gilly may be looking to do what he did in Singapore and take the tyres for a lot longer than everyone else does. As he goes on to the super soft tyres, there's Carnes, sticking to the original strategy maybe, and Johannes, that's the medium tyre.
Wow, he's going for a one stop. The pit crew were a bit late out there. I don't know what was happening there. Did he maybe called it very late? I'm not sure, but anyway, slightly slow stop.
So,
but Hickey's got in front of Carnes.
Yes, so Hickey has jumped Carnes, but only just. And we know Carnes is on the softer tyre and the fresher tyres. So Hickey's going to have a hard job defending. Johannes has come out 8 seconds behind these guys and only a second clear of Maynard. He was actually closer than what it is now, as we've got yellows in sector two for an unknown reason at the moment.
Can't see who that is.
In a car that is not moving.
Oh, that's Gilly. Gilly's had off. Oh no! Oh, and Carnes and Hickey have gone straight on.
Hickey and Carnes have both gone wide. Which means Gilly has kept second place.
Basically the same order we had after that straight. So
except now Noob is clear of them all. This has helped out Noob massively.
So Gilly went off, Hickey and Khan's passed them, Khan's went for an overtake on Hickey, and then it all went back to the way it was. So Gilly is now in second, although Gilly was leading, I suppose, wasn't he?
Yeah, not quite sure what was going on originally with Gilly to even set up that, as Hickey now trying to go around the outside of Gilly.
Oh!
And Gilly has just kept
and
it
Hickey's
out of the barriers.
As well.
I think maybe Gilly was looking to go into the pits there, and Hickey was on the other side of the circuit, which prevented him from doing so. So Carnes is now a lot clearer of Hickey, and Johannes is right behind him, and he goes past.
Johannes goes into P3. Disaster for Hickey there. That's just unfortunate.
I think it was a case of Gilly wanting to come into the pits, and Hickey essentially blocking his path unbeknowingly. But with that incident, it might be a battle between Khan's and Noob for the win now.
Yeah, we'll have to see what Khan's can do on his super soft compared to Noob's soft tyres. But yeah, I think you might be right here. Unless we have a safety car or anything odd happens, which it can do.
As Lopez is now only a tenth behind Purple Petrol, who's not having his best race, to be fair to him. And he has got past as they're going down the back straight. Purple Petrol has finished in the points in every single race bar one. Lopez has finished in the points every single race. Neither of them are in the points at the moment.
Yeah, not going well. We've got someone in the pits ahead.
Yellows. Wise of the Dragons doing a Lewis Hamilton and not being able to get into the pits there. Yeah, Khan's a Noob. The gap was over 3 seconds, and now it's only 1.2. So Khan's is really going to fancy this win. He is on the softer, fresher tyres. And Hickey, looking at the back of Johannes' McLaren, is going to stick there for a moment. Johannes doing a very good job on those medium tyres. And as you say, could well take those to the end.
Yellow flag, sector one.
Yeah, and that's Wise of the Dragons. Yeah. We saw him have difficulty getting into the pits, now exiting the pits. A couple of corners later, he's got trouble again.
Having a bit of a nightmare out there as Wise of the Dragons.
As Sam is closing up on his teammate, it's 1.7 between the two guys now.
Yeah, no, he's not as close, is he? But he will still get DRS.
Yep, you'll see the effect of DRS take place from this camera angle. He will get closer and closer, bigger and bigger.
But not big enough.
No. Ultimately, he didn't seem to make up that much time, actually.
Yeah, quite big on the brakes there. That was good. Good underbreaker for Hickey. He made up a lot of time there.
Yeah, still about 6 tenths in Hickey. Yeah, into the pits. That's a lot earlier than I thought, actually. Maybe he's looking to go onto the medium tyres and then just go to the end.
We'll have to see. So this will promote... Well, Main is coming in too. So Bilal Khan is promoted to fifth, and which will be fourth. As he gets past, medium tyres then for Jack Hickey. He's going till the end of the race then.
Yep, and Maynard should be putting on the same tyre compound just behind him. These two not looking to pit again, not even halfway through the race. And
Sam has got past his teammate into fifth place now then.
Yeah.
And Hickey's just come up behind the pair of them. This will be interesting.
An overtake or team orders?
It was an overtake. He did put up a fight, but I do think he played fair because we're on the same team.
Fair enough. And Jack Hickey is just behind the two guys. And on those new tyres, albeit mediums, as Siema's got a 5 second stop go for speeding in the pit lane.
It's not a late breaking race without one of those bad boys being thrown out.
Not as many as we had in Silverstone, that's for sure, as Hickey
needs
looks
to be careful here.
Yeah, might need to bide his time. Khan's is so close to getting in DRS range now, it's literally just over a second, but we will stay on board with these two guys because Hickey is just a tenth away from DJ Marshall. He will get DRS from Sam, that's going to help him a great deal.
Yeah, and it means Hickey's not
going
to get
Hickey
back.
Is going to look to the outside, and I think he's got better traction out of that corner.
We got a yellow in sector one, and
the Toro Rosso picks up the place and will now go after Sam Sage, the Googles, who is in fifth.
Khan's has finally got into that second window. 1 second window, I should say.
And we've got continuing yellows in sector one and sector two, but we can't ask the McLaren.
Oh,
that's Pat O'Hagan. Pat O'Hagan. Not out of the race, but not in a good spot either.
You're going the wrong way, Pat.
Yeah, he has retired. Yes. So Pat and Curly Apex out of the session. Khan's right on the back of Noob. He's going to be desperate for a win here. He is just behind the top two guys and Sam. So a win would go a long way with not many rounds left in the championship. He'll get DRS. He's going to be right behind him even before the DRS kicks in. And he's going to go on the inside trying to overtake Noob, the championship leader, into the hairpin. Noob doing his best to stick it around the outside, and he's going to have a bit of better line coming out of the corner. But I think Khan's is just about done enough.
He has. Meanwhile, we've got Hickey, who's just behind Samuel Sage in fifth place.
Yeah, as they go onto the same area we were just talking about with Khan's and Noob. Sam goes to the inside. Hickey follows him, desperate to get that slipstream.
Not enough this time.
And Hickey stays behind for the moment, but that battle is far from over. Hickey once again on the DRS. Of course, the start finish straight a lot shorter, so less of an opportunity to make a move. Will that prevent him? It will for the time being.
Oh, very close.
Hickey looking up the inside. There might have been a brush of wheels there, but they're both okay.
Both through, that was close, but it was fair. But I can't, they just up the road from them as well.
Yeah, they may factor into that battle soon enough. Hickey ideally wants to be battling with the top two guys, obviously on a completely different strategy. But a key to that strategy is making use of the fresh tyres whilst they are still fresh. Staying behind Sam isn't going to help him at all.
He's gone for it.
Oh, that's not a usual overtaking spot, and he does back out when he realises it isn't going to happen.
Yeah, this is all going well so far. Tricky long right-hander. Got to get a good exit if you want to make any sort of an overtake, and I think Hickey has.
Yeah, Noob is in the pits from second place, so that will be his second and final stop. Hickey. And now Hickey's got the DRS. He's closer than he was last time out. Is he going to be able to make a move stick this time? As he dives to the inside, the switchback from Hickey.
Oh, Hickey, mate, you're just blocking off the whole curb.
Nah, that was a beautiful move. That was a lovely little dummy. Khan's in the pits.
Yeah, Khan's, he's done eight laps on the first set of super softs, and he's done eight on those as well. This should be the soft tyre. It is. So we now know Khan's and Noob, and indeed Hickey and Sam, none of those need to pit anymore.
So will Noob have gained an advantage by doing the undercut?
We'll have to wait and see. I think he might have done.
He has, but I don't think...
They're going to come out very close going into turn one. Noob has retaken second place for the moment. Johannes is in the lead, but he has to pit once more. So this battle is essentially for P1.
And they're both on the same tyres. Wow, so that undercut did work. Noob must have had a flying outlap on those new soft tyres.
Yeah, I think Noob just about did enough on those soft tyres on the second stint. Obviously, he went a slightly different strategy. The incident with Hickey slowed Khan's down a bit, and that might have saved Noob for the moment.
Pumper doesn't trip out of the way, which should give Noob DRS, to be fair.
I don't think Purple Petrol's going to do a Jean-Pierre Jarier, but you never know.
We can't call him Jean-Pierre Petrol.
No, it doesn't quite
Jean-Pierre
work.
Jean-Pierre Harry J, more like.
Yeah.
Hey. Well,
so
I'm making overtake, by the way.
Sam has managed to get past Mayner. I did see...
It was around the fast corner. It was quite good.
Yeah,
it's quite good.
I saw the gap between you guys was a fair bit. I didn't think that battle was going to emerge for another couple laps yet, but apparently not.
Yeah, he went round the left hander a little bit wide, then locked up going into that right hander that immediately follows, but he went wide, Tigers dived down the inside. He's gone wide again, he's off the track.
Yeah, Mayner having a bit of trouble. Obviously, he's onto those medium tyres, one stopping this race.
Yeah, his main battle is with DJ Marshall, who's 7 seconds down the road, but we'll be hoping to try and catch him.
Yeah, slightly fresher tyres, but not all that much. But if Maynard goes off the road any more times, that will get close.
They're not catching Johannes at a massive rate of knots at the moment. They took half a second out of him in that last sector.
Yeah, but with 10 laps to go,
it's going to be at least a second a lap. And if they're battling each other, who knows?
Could these two hold each other up enough to give Johannes a debut win? The scenes that would be caused by that.
Well, we'll have to wait and see what happens, but it's entirely possible. They have taken another 3 tenths in that first sector alone, but... Oh, another 2 tenths. Maybe we're speaking too soon, but it could happen. We'll have to wait and see.
Yeah, it will be fascinating to watch. Johannes' alternate strategy is really spicing up this race. If it wasn't spicy enough already with Noob and Khan's battling out on circuit.
It was a korma.
We all like a Chinese curry. Yeah, a lot of spice.
It's like a balti now.
I'm going to announce my retirement from commentary.
Oh, thank God.
Yeah. Whoa, Sam, it's me and you for the win now.
Yes, mate, we have got this on lockdown.
Lockdown?
Lockdown. Alrighty.
So, Hickey is gradually reining in the other Red Bull of Bilal Khan. The gap is now at 1.8 seconds.
And Bilal Khan is into the pits. That's very, very true.
Go from China.
We might be quite close between you and Bilal Khan in a minute, so that might interrupt your singing.
Super soft, there's not a chance. I've just got a penalty as well because I've just cut the corner by accident. For Christ's sake.
Well,
this is an awful race for me.
If there's any lesson to be learned,
Bilal.
Don't sing. Yeah, and
Bilal
Khan is just in front of Sam, but as Sam said earlier, Bilal Khan is on the super soft tyres compared to Sam's slightly worn medium tyres. That's the thing, Khan's really needs to win, but at the same time, if he were to have a collision that cost him places, that would almost put him out of championship contention.
Got DRS again.
I'm out of championship contention, I think.
Still a few races to go yet.
Including Monaco. And Khan's
so close.
So close to the back of Noob.
Not enough. They haven't taken that much out of Johannes this lap. Not as much, at least, anyway.
Yeah, 7.5 seconds. I mean, could we see a last lap puncture? We've seen it before with Sam in Malaysia.
Khan. Please don't talk about it.
Khan's is doing still everything works. He can. He's going left and right. We've got a yellow in sector 3. Who's that?
Yeah, it's a car that's reappeared on the track.
Yeah, it's Wise of the Dragons again.
Yeah, Wise of the Dragons has been in the wars all day. He's in 13th place still.
This.
He reappeared in my car. It was quite scary.
This is riveting. This is two of the championship contenders going at it. They've been going at it lap after lap.
There is really nothing to separate them.
Khan's will get DRS again. Looks like he's got a slightly better exit than Noob. He's a bit wide this time. Yeah, this could be the one.
Yeah, this could be the lap. Is it lap 21 where Khan's finally gets past Noob and puts himself in contention for the win? Noob has gone to the outside and he's actually clipped the grass there. Hasn't slowed him down at all. Khan's has got the racing line now. And he's looking to switch back. And I think Noob just about maintains it for the time being.
This is great racing. Noob.
What's happening with DJ Marshall and Maynard? Sorry, they look all very close on track together.
Yeah, Maynard, DJ Marshall just 1.3 behind or 1.1 behind.
Sorry.
As Khan goes for a move up the inside. Has he managed to make it stick? He has. What a move by the Ferrari driver.
That was a huge move. I didn't see that one coming at all, but he cut back beautifully going into turn one. Now he's got 7 laps to make up 7 seconds for the lead. We'll have to see how this goes. Might drag a Noob with him, we'll see.
Can Khan's claim his fourth victory in this second half of the season? He's on a good run of form and he needs to be if he wants to stay in championship contention. But of course, the man to look out for is that McLaren driver, Johannes. Still going on the medium tyres.
He's going to have DRS this time round rather than Khan's. We'll see how this goes.
Yeah, maybe the battle isn't over yet. And Khan's is, as a precautionary measure, going to defend the inside line. I don't think Noob was quite close enough anyway, but
he's going back, and there's
contact! A brush of the tyres there, and I think Noob has got second place again. Ocon's nips off the inside. They've both run wide. Noob is going to have DRS once again.
Johannes the win.
Well, yeah, Johannes has jumped 8 seconds up the road again now.
If these two keep on battling, there's no doubt as to who's going to win the race.
Noob retakes second. No, this is so close. Noob's run wide, and Carnes is going to take second place back again.
Carnes survives a mini heart attack there.
Wow, that was incredible stuff. I mean, a little bit of contact, but it was all pretty much fair.
But the thing is, that it was this kind of gap, this time last lap. Carnes needs to extend it if he wants to defend against Noob on the straight again.
Yeah.
If it's going to be 3-4 tenths separating them again, Noob's going to have the chance to do exactly the same thing.
That DRS is very powerful, isn't it?
No doubt about it. Slipstream plus DRS equals fast.
Thanks for that, Matt. Sam. Sorry.
Don't think that that's something I would say. I'm
Thanks for that, Matt. Ben. Meanwhile, DJ Marshall is only 6 tenths behind Mayner, as Noob is going to get DRS again. Here we go. I have to take a deep breath.
So he nearly got the job done last lap. Can he get the job done this lap? Carnes defends the inside line, and it's almost a carbon copy.
They're doing it again. Here we go.
And Carnes is stuck it there.
Noob's
He's still
right
there.
The
I think there was minor contact actually with the hand raise. Oh, it's so close.
Oh, and Carnes has done the same as Noob this time, but Noob's up the inside. We'll see who comes out on top.
I think Noob has
no. He's
no.
Not. Carnes is back in front. Gee, I'm going to have a lie down.
I think the only person loving this battle more than the two of us is Johannes, who is actually extending his gap.
Yeah, it's now up to 8 seconds. I mean, it's basically the same as it was this time last lap.
If those tyres last, it is a debut win for the McLaren driver. Bilal Khan is right on the back of Gilly. And yeah, they're going into the hairpin side by side. And there is contact there, I think.
There's more contact!
Oh, no! They're both gone!
Gilly's out!
Gilly's retired once more!
Sam's going to benefit and get 2 places. He's up to 5th.
I can give the position back.
Oh no, it's because of the yellow flags.
Bilal Khan's in the pits.
So Bilal Khan has gone into the pits because of the front wing damage he incurred. Even more front wing damage for Gilly. He's out of the race. That is devastating. And he hasn't quite done enough laps to claim points.
I was going to pay attention to this.
Yeah, I think
battle.
This is the battle that's going
to actually, Lopez is the one to look out for.
Yeah, Lopez is right on the back of DJ Marshall. Is he going to give it a go? Not yet. He's perhaps going to wait for the straight. But DJ Marshall will pick up DRS off of Mayner.
Gilly's car is still brimming there, good God.
Yeah, I know, nightmare.
Oh, and Lopez has got much better traction there, and he's actually got DJ Marshall before the straight.
He's had him for breakfast.
And he'll still get the DRS.
Ooh.
And DJ Marshall not planning on giving it up, and he's gone for it.
Oh, and Lopez cut back.
Beautiful stuff.
That was sexy driving there from Lopez. Love that.
And now he'll go about perhaps getting Mayner, who's holding both of them off at the minute in 6th place.
Yeah, the gap up at the front between Carnes and Noob is now 1.2, so out of DRS range for
Lopez. That is close.
Careful. Come on, he's still on for a good... Oh, he's going to run up the inside of him.
Lopez not hanging about at all.
Mayner's
he's got one
go
place and he's looking for another. He does leave enough room for the Toro Rosso driver.
Yeah.
The Williams driver?
Yeah. It's not a Williams. Don't know what you're talking about.
The Williams Rosso.
Oh, Mayner's
gone
for it.
Oh, Mayner has gone for it once more, and he's actually gone off the circuit a little bit, and DJ Marshall is in behind them once more.
Mayner, he doesn't like to give up, does he? And
he's still not giving up. Sticks it there, and Lopez, I think, finally does have the corner.
Oh, thank God my internet was about to go. It hasn't. Oh, praise the Lord. Purple petrol is dancing in my face.
Oh, dear.
Oh, and Bilal Khan's got a massively better exit out of there.
And there's very close to contact there.
Oh, yeah.
Bilal Khan is going to have the place there.
It's So Johannes.
Johannes has just got a couple more corners to negotiate here.
I don't believe this has happened.
He has been an absolute king on those medium tyres. He's taken them so many laps, and Johannes, for the first time in his first race, is going to take victory at the Chinese Grand Prix. And Kant is going to follow home in second, and Noob is going to claim a podium in third.
Can only be happy with that, to be honest, Noob. I know he wanted the win, but
I think that's a good result on the balance. He's got Hickey and Sam behind him rather than in front of him, and Carnes, who is his most distant challenger, is only gained 3 points on him as Hickey crosses the line to finish fourth.
Yeah. So Sam is going to come across the line after a pretty good recovery drive for fifth place. Better than the way he started anyway, Sam. Up two places. Lopez is going to have for him.
Yeah, Lopez has managed to extend the gap ahead of Mayner, who is battling with Bilal Khan, actually. So seventh place is going to go right down to the wire.
And Bilal's got it.
Yeah, Bilal Khan, this is where he had contact with Gilly, actually, and they very nearly have contact again. This is going to go down to the final corner. Lopez is going to claim sixth. Who's going to claim seventh?
Maynard's disconnected.
Oh, Maynard's disconnected. What an anti-climax.
He's out of fuel.
Oh, no. Maynard is out of fuel, which means his battle with Bilal Khan is going to be handed to the Red Bull driver.
Only just made it in front of DJ Marshall there at the end as well.
Yeah. Let's head to the podium. So there you can see, we haven't seen a McLaren on the podium all year long. And Johannes, in his first drive, there you have it. Takes the top step. Alongside him, Carnes and Noob, regular features on the podium. This really does make it an interesting championship battle with just four rounds to go now.
I know, I can't believe it, but things are really hotting up now, aren't they?
Monaco, Brazil, Mexico and Belgium, and then that will be it. So there's confirmation of it. Johannes wins the race in his McLaren. That one stop proving very good indeed. Carnes was in second, Noob was in third, Jack Hickey in fourth place, Sam Sage the Googles in fifth. So all the championship protagonists second through to fifth. Lopez in sixth recovered fairly well. Seventh was Bilal Khan, who had that incident with Gilly. Eighth place was Mayner, who ran out of fuel just before the end. DJ Marshall picks up his first points in ninth. Siema a lap down in tenth. Purple Petrol, a rare non-score for him in 11th. Wiser the Dragons is 12th, our last runner. And then the three retirements, Gilly, who was certainly in the points, and Pat O'Hagan, Curly Apex, didn't finish the race either. And that's going to do it for coverage of round 16, the Chinese Grand Prix. I've been Ben Hocking.
I've been Harry Ead.
And I've been the man moaning. I've been Samuel Sage.
Next week, Monaco at night. Do not miss it. And remember, keep braking late.